Hey, this is Alissa from Arch Enemy, and we're here at the Little Choc Apothecary in Brooklyn, and we're gonna go have some vegan food, so come on. For me, the absolute baseline of veganism is that it's an ethical stance against imposing suffering on others. It's not a diet, it's not about a trend, it's not about looking good, it's not about judging anyone. It's really, really just about wanting to limit the amount of suffering that you create in the world. And the easiest way to do this isn't by changing your life drastically, it's just by making a slightly different choice with your life. If you have the choice to have that coffee with cow's milk or almond milk, you can just choose the almond milk. And now you've contributed less to someone's suffering. If you have that choice to have that veggie burger or a beef burger, you can just choose the veggie burger. So it's very, very easy. It doesn't cost any money. It doesn't cost any more time. It's just a matter of choosing compassion. And that's the most important thing that I wish people would realize. Just realize what it is. It's an ethical stance. I think that people maybe think that, you know, I go around in this like weird bubble of needing very specific things and being high maintenance, and it's not like that. It's just so easy. There's actually a lot of vegans in metal. Veganism obviously has some scientifically proven health benefits, and being on the road is a very physically strenuous thing. You know, we often go with no sleep or very little sleep. We sweat our asses off on stage. You know, we're doing a lot of unnatural movements or unnatural sounds in my case. And I definitely think that just by, you know, respecting my body and listening to my body and knowing what I need, I'm able to just be at the top of my game as a vocalist. And so that involves just, I mean, I would be vegan either way, but I'm just happy that vegan happens to be really healthy also. I find it really funny when people accuse vegans of preaching, because first of all, I've been vegan since the 90s, and so if you're just getting butthurt about it now, where were you for the last 20 years? You know what I mean? I mean, I can post something and I don't even say vegan in it, or it's not about veganism, but maybe like it says vegan like on my shirt or like on my bag, or I have like a little patch or something. And then it doesn't matter what else is in the photo, people will focus in on that and just be like, ah, how do you know someone's vegan? They'll tell you. And it's like, well, no, it's more like, how do you know someone's extremely defensive about their lifestyle? They'll find a vegan and get mad. I've never in person had anybody tell me that I'm preaching or being preachy towards them, and I never have done that, you know? I don't judge people based on their choices. But what it comes down to also, and I challenge anybody to do this, whether you're watching TV, watch TV for 10 minutes, or walk down the street in a city for 10 minutes, and count the amount of advertisings you see for fast food restaurants, leather bags and purses, animal-tested cosmetics like perfume or makeup. Count the amount of advertisings you see that involve animal cruelty, and then count the amount of advertisements you see about veganism. And I've done this, and within a 10-minute period of watching TV, there were zero advertisements about veganism, or even just about vegan things. Like, you don't see an ad for like broccoli or an ad for apples, but you will see an ad for McDonald's or Arby's or a fur coat or a leather interior of a car or something like that. And so really, what we're being preached is animal products, but we're so conditioned to think that it's okay that we don't see it anymore. And what we haven't seen before is veganism, and so people are noticing this now, and now it's starting to kind of screw with what their conditioned norm has always been, and that's why people get defensive about it, I think. Veganism has always been something that I've, you know, thought about when it comes to lyric writing, because if I'm going to be screaming about something, I need to like be passionate about it. So it has to be something that I really, really think about a lot and really want to express in a loud way. I always like walk into studio with like a plethora of beverages. So I usually have some coffee. Sometimes it's decaf, but I usually have some coffee. I always have hot water with, like, I slice ginger and lemon and I put that in hot water and I drink that throughout the course of the studio recording. So I usually also bring in like a protein shake. I'll take either like Vega protein powder or some other vegan protein powder, and I'll blenderize that with like a banana and maybe some like peanut butter, some water or almond milk or whatever. And so that's usually what I have like just in the studio. But then in the making of Will to Power, I think I was, I don't know, what was I eating a lot of? I ate a lot, I don't know. I love all sorts of food. I'm like a big fan of almost every kind of food, so as long as it's vegan. So I don't know what I ate that much of, except where I was in Sweden, the best vegan options I could find were actually like, it was like a Thai place, so I was eating red curry a lot. If you're new to veganism and you're traveling somewhere, there's an app called Happy Cow that I very much recommend because it sort of geolocates you wherever you are and it tells you the nearest vegan restaurants or organic stores or things where you can get vegan food. But also, let's not forget that, like, you know what an apple looks like and a banana, and if you're really stuck, you can always go into a grocery store and just buy some fruits, buy some vegetables, you can buy a can of beans if you want, there's all sorts of things that are vegan. Yeah, there's a lot of sanctuaries and like animal rescues going on, which is fantastic, and I'm so happy to see that happening nowadays. I really like Motley Zoo, which is like a sort of pet-based animal sanctuary, an animal rescue. I think they're based in Seattle. And they're kind of cool because they like totally support the music scene too. They'll come out to shows and they'll have like little kittens or puppies that are like named Ozzy Osbourne or you know, they'll have one named, you know, Doyle or whatever. And so, like, you know, it's kind of cute that they're just associating these two things that I love. And some other ones that deal with the animals that most people don't necessarily view as deserving of rights, like cows and pigs and chickens and turkeys. And I think that those are extremely important too, because rather than bringing young people to a zoo or somewhere that enslaves animals, you could bring them here and teach them how beautiful these animals are, and maybe they would grow up to not want to be eating them anymore. There's a lot of awareness about veganism, and even the people that like bash veganism are actually just helping to like spread the word about it, so thank you. Like, there's just vegan.com, or I mean, you can just Google anything about it. Like, Google will lead you to all sorts of vegan recipes, resources. I'm sure there's forums like on Facebook and stuff like that where you can maybe talk to other vegans that can give you advice. I know just looking on Instagram, you can find vegan personal trainers, bodybuilders, nutritionists, diet coaches. I think that it's all there. It's all really easy. You just have to get into it and take a look. And if this is something that you're not sure about and you're just starting to consider, I really highly recommend watching the documentaries that most people watch, and then that's their catalyst. Earthlings, What the Health, Cowspiracy, Veducated, Forks Over Knives. There's so many of them now. There's a lot of really, really good ones, and they're all Fat, Sick, and Nearly Dead is another one. And some of them focus more on the environmental aspects that veganism solves, or on the health issues that veganism solves, or on the animal welfare that needs to be addressed and that veganism helps to address. And then when you feel ready, you can actually just make that change. And, you know, it becomes super easy after a while. So please check out Will to Power. That's our latest record with Arch Enemy. It comes out September 8th, and I hope you guys love it as much as we do.